I regret the necessities of war have compelled us to bomb North Vietnam. We have carefully limited those raids. They've been directed at concrete and steel.
Soon here at ringside with my colleague Jesse the Body Ventura as we bring you another outstanding week of professional wrestling featuring the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation, and this week just a blockbuster.
That's right, Gorilla. We got the Killer Bees. We got the tough guy from the Double Cross Ranch, Terry Funk. We got my tag team partner, the Macho Man, Randy Savage. And we got the big man from the hills, Uncle Elmer.
You forgot about Elizabeth, Jess. How on earth could you possibly do that? Plenty of excitement and action, so let's get with it. Let's go up to our ring announcer, Norman Kimber.
Ladies and gentlemen, this tag team match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing 235 pounds, Frank Marconi. His partner from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing 240 pounds, Barry O. Their opponents now about to approach the ring. The Killer Bees. First from Florida, weighing 232 pounds, B. Brian Blair. And his partner from White Bear Lake, Minnesota, weighing 230 pounds, Jumping Jim Brunzell.
Holy mackerel, what a following the Killer Bees have put together here in the World Wrestling Federation, Jess. Just unreal.
Well, I'll tell you, Gorilla, they've had a lot of success of late, and it just goes to show you sometimes you don't have to be the biggest. If you got desire, you can still be the best.
You said a mouthful that time. Two tremendous athletes, both collegiate and now professional. Look at this monkey flip right off the bat as Barry O got trapped, suckered right in there. Jumping Jim Brunzell shows me something, Jess. He shows me that he's got determination, guts, and speed and agility and wrestling knowledge. And when you put all those things together, you can't help but be successful.
Well, I'll tell you, Gorilla, you're talking so good that I better watch my step, or the next time I gotta wrestle, you're liable to have the Killer Bees down here commentating.
Well, if you decide to team up with the Macho Man, as you've said for so many weeks now, I made a statement one night when you were not present that the only reason you made that tag team combination was to get close to Elizabeth.
You believe that?
Yeah, I do, Jess. I think I do, yeah. With your reputation, you could have any tag team partner you wanted.
Well, I'll tell you, jealousy will get you nowhere. Wow.
Sometimes jealousy will get you everywhere. B. Brian Blair. Outstanding amateur background, and we were so glad to see that down in Tampa, Florida, I believe it was, Jess, they had B. Brian Blair Day, in which they honored him for doing so much work with the youngsters.
Yeah, but he does it for nothing. You'd never catch Jesse the Body doing nothing for nothing.
Give me a break.
I always have an ulterior motive. There better be money involved.
On Monday, November the 4th, Maple Leaf Wrestling and the stars of the World Wrestling Federation return to the Brantford Civic Center with all the action getting underway at 7:30 p.m. And on Tuesday, November the 5th, Maple Leaf Wrestling presents a spectacular card in the Oshawa Civic Auditorium featuring King Kong Bundy. And on Sunday, October the 27th, promoter Jack Tunney will present another action-packed card in Toronto's Maple Leaf Garden. In an intercontinental title match, Tito Santana puts his title on the line against Cowboy Ace Orton. Hillbilly Jim will battle Big John Studd. Terrible Terry Funk faces the Junkyard Dog. And topping it off, the Battle of the Giants. Andre the French Giant goes up against King Kong Bundy. Remember, that's on Sunday, October the 27th, 7:30 p.m. in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. And join us tonight for the World Wrestling Federation from 7 to 8 p.m. right here on Channel 11.
Barry O and injured that leg earlier. They worked on it, so he couldn't really go for a cover there. He hurt himself probably just as much as Brunzell on that move.
Well, these guys are exciting, and so many exciting things going on in the World Wrestling Federation today. Jess, we got that tremendous cartoon out of Hogan's Rockin' Wrestling. Have you seen any of that, Jeff? It is great.
Well, not really, Gorilla. I usually am up and out too late. I don't get up that early in the morning.
Oh, there's the bee sting and the clothesline by B. Bryan. As he's going to work, suplex coming up. Couldn't get him up. Got him up the second time. Look at the continuity here as another quick tag is made. Jumping Jim's in. Double slingshot. In goes Marconi. Big backdrop. Marconi made that one easy. He went right over the back and down, Jess. He didn't want to go up at all. It was a smart maneuver on his part.
Well, I'll tell you, the Killer Bees are using that 4-5 count completely to their advantage.
Look at this. Atomic drop right into a beautiful standing drop kick. And down for the cover. B. Bryan Blair. It's all over. Probably one of the most devastating drop kicks in professional wrestling, possessed by Jumpy Jim Brunzell. These two guys are exciting, and the fans certainly appreciate them. Let's get the official word.
The winners of the match, the Killer Bees.
Killer Bees stinging the team of Marconi and Mario. Let's go back and take a look.
Well, here's some double team action right here. Marconi shooting, jumping Jim Brunzell in. Brunzell hooks the ropes. Marconi standing there. The tag has been made. Bryan Blair comes in. Beautiful atomic drop right here. Wham! Straightens him right up. Jimmy Brunzell times the drop kick, puts it right on the chin. Bryan Blair dropping the elbow on. A good series of tag team moves right there. A combination to get that three count.
Marconi couldn't stand the avalanche by the Killer Bees. Exciting here in the World Wrestling Federation. Stay with us, wrestling fans. A special WWF update coming up.
Update this week focuses on King Kong Bundy, a giant of a man who has been running roughshod over all opponents since coming to the World Wrestling Federation. Here we see him interfering in a match between Big John Studd and Andre the French Giant. As a result of this, Andre the Giant was sidelined for approximately 6 weeks. However, as you all know by now, Andre the Giant has recovered from the ruptured sternum, and he's determined to get a hold of King Kong Bundy and even the score. And when he does, it's a match that you certainly won't want to miss. It'll be the Battle of the Giants.
Can your motor oil survive the punishment today's engines dish out? Circulating it twice as fast, working it twice as hard, breaking it down, and causing it to lose its viscosity. That's why you need an oil with the additive that does more to help prevent viscosity breakdown. Castrol XLR, the oil engineered for today's cars. Look for Castrol XLR at these and other leading retailers. It's everybody's responsibility to be aware of danger on a construction site. Awareness is know-how. We've got it. Let's use it. Produced by your Construction Safety Association.
The big crunch with the big cheese taste.
Cheese!
Doritos, they taste as good as they crunch.
For 75 years, Canadians have rolled on Goodyear tires. Now, Goodyear's premium radios are sale priced during our spectacular 75th anniversary sale. Like Vector, our best all-season for exceptional year-round handling. and the famous Goodyear F32S ice radio for extra winter traction. Featured is our superb steel-belted radio polysteel from $49.95. Our 75th anniversary sale. Goodyear quality at super sale prices. See your participating Goodyear retailer today.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing 235 pounds, Bob Marcus. Now I'd like to introduce the manager, the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. Now introducing, from the Double Cross Ranch in Amarillo, Texas, weighing 260 pounds, Terry Funk.
From the Double Cross Ranch in Texas. Couldn't quite make that out.
Says something or other, referring obviously to the JYD, the Junkyard Dog, and as everyone knows, Terry Funk from the Double Cross Ranch has no love whatsoever for the Junkyard Dog.
Boy, they got a thing going, a vendetta going between those two.
On Monday, November the 4th, Maple Leaf Wrestling and the Stars of the World Wrestling Federation return to the Brantford Civic Center with all the action getting underway at 7:30 p.m. And on Tuesday, November the 5th, Maple Leaf Wrestling presents a spectacular card in the Oshawa Civic Auditorium featuring King Kong Bundy. And on Sunday, October the 27th, promoter Jack Tunney will present another action-packed card in Toronto's Maple Leaf Garden. In an intercontinental title match, Tito Santana puts his title on the line against Cowboy Ace Orton. Hillbilly Jim will battle Big John Studd. Terrible Terry Funk faces the Junkyard Dog. And topping it off, the Battle of the Giants. Andre the French Giant goes up against King Kong Bundy. Remember, that's on Sunday, October the 27th, 7:30 p.m. in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. And join us tonight for the World Wrestling Federation from 7 to 8 p.m. right here on Channel 11.
Did Terry Funk make a recording as well, Jess?
No, I don't believe so. I think it was just about... He's just giving you a little play-by-play, Gorilla. Compliments of the mouth of the South.
He gets close enough to me. Look at this. Terry Funk on the receiving end as Bob Marcus starts him off. He had some things going there, but they got stopped in a hurry by the man from the Double Cross Ranch. Look out. Whoa, he went for a pile driver. Marcus dumped him over the top rope. Terry Funk didn't waste any time getting back inside the squared circle, though. This guy sometimes is just immune to pain, Jess. And Funk stops him as he's coming in, but only momentarily. Look out now, Irish whip. Marcus into the corner. There's a sleeper hole. Slapped on. Patented job by Terry Funk. Got the youngster right in the center of the ring. I believe the lights are going to go out.
And the mouth of the South is warming up the Brandon Iron, Gorilla. There it is. You can see it in the background. The Brandon Iron's in the toes.
Despicable things should not be allowed here in the World Wrestling Federation. Spoken to a number of people on the rules committee. There it goes. The youngster went out. Referee calling for the bell. Make him break the hole before he does some kind of permanent damage. Up and get the official word.
How do you like that?
The winner of the match, Terry Funk.
Look out, he's got that right in his hand. Get away from him. That is humiliating. He already humiliated the youngster enough.
Bob Marcus is a marked man, courtesy of Terry Funk from the Double Cross Ranch.
Well, he's got to bring this youngster back to consciousness. Now he's got it. Well, he certainly doesn't need to do that. Give me a break, referee.
That's just shaking the cobwebs out of his head.
Chalking up another victory here in the World Wrestling Federation. There's no place in the World Wrestling Federation for our Brandon Iron Terry Funk. Well, you condone that kind of action, do you, Jess?
I don't condone it, but to me, it's at times, it's a nice little highlight.
Let's go back and take a look at the sleeper hole as applied. As only Terry Funk, the man from the Double Cross Ranch, can do it.
Here you can see Bob Marcus. He's out. He's in dreamland right now.
Funk puts the youngster asleep, chalks up another victory here in the World Wrestling Federation. Stay with us, wrestling fans. The most interesting interview coming your way in just a moment.
On Monday, November the 4th, Maple Leaf Wrestling, the stars of the World Wrestling Federation, return to the Brantford Civic Center. All the action getting underway at 7:30 p.m. And on Sunday, October the 27th, remember the new starting time, 7:30 p.m. in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. Promoter Jack Tunney has come up with another spectacular card. In a ladies' world title match, Wendy Richter puts her title on the line against the Spider Lady. Hillbilly Jim faces Big John Studd. In an intercontinental title match, Tito Santana will risk his title against Cowboy Ace Horton. Terrible Terry Funk will take on the Junkyard Dog, and topping it off, Andre the French Giant will go against King Kong Bundy. And Captain Lou Albano, I know you've got your man ready.
Yes, let me tell you something, Big Red. Yes, this man was hurt. Yes, it was all engineered by Bobby Heenan when they took John Studd and King Kong Bundy and hurt this man. But now let me tell you this. Now Bundy is one-on-one. And now Andre, the 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th wonder of the world, is completely healed and ready. The greatest athlete the world has ever known. The only undefeated athlete in the world today. He is ready. He's 100%, all 500 pounds. Hear it from Andre. Go ahead, boss.
King Kong Bundy, if you're a smart wrestler or a smart guy, you should talk and ask to Big John Studd what happened to him. He tried to challenge me all the way, but I still undefeated. I slammed him, I beat him in the cage, I did everything to him. I even started to cut your hair, John Studd. But King Kong Bundy, you put your nose on some business that doesn't belong to you. I'm not ready, I'm not to finish with John Studd, but before I go, come back to you, John Studd, King Kong Bundy, believe me, you tried to put me out of the business. It did not take you too long to be in the business. I'm going to take you, and you're going to make you pay to go to stay in this business, and you're going to pay the giant way.
Bundy, be ready. Bundy, be ready, because we're
remember that Sunday, October the 27th, new starting time, 7:30 p.m., right here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Garden. I'd like to remind everyone in the Oshawa area that Maple Leaf Wrestling will present a spectacular card in the Oshawa Civic Auditorium on Tuesday, November the 5th. All the action gets underway at 8 p.m., and this big band beside me, King Kong Bundy, will be in the feature event.
That's right, and you know they can find a man with the guts to get in the ring with King Kong Bundy. You know what's going to happen to him. He's going to get thrown into the turnbuckle. He's going to get squashed with a big avalanche, and he's going to get a five count. One, two, three, four, five.
Remember, that's the Oshawa Civic Auditorium, Tuesday, November the 5th. All the action getting underway at 8 p.m.
I'll be back in 5 minutes.
When I bite into a crispy crunch, I'm off to a world of taste. A crispy, crunchy, chocolatey, munchy, peanut buttery place. A place where nothing else matters, cause chocolate covers the ground. Just when you think you're in paradise, peanut butter starts melting around. It's crispy, crunchy, melty, munchy, wonderful kind of fun. And I've still got 2 minutes left, and I'm not coming back till I've done.
Crispy Crunch, what a wonderful place to be.
A slow leak and a long way to go. Winifred Kovacek had a lot on her mind when she pulled into George Raymond's busy Shell station.
Oh, you can't keep driving on that. I'll have my husband take a look at it.
Oh, thank you.
There's a woman out front.
Not every Shell dealer can take time out to squeeze in another repair. But that day, the Raymonds did.
Well, looks like the rim has been. But we'll have her fixed in no time flat.
Okay, bye-bye.
We're proud of Shell dealers like the Raymonds. Shell people who help.
Burger King realizes that the competition isn't exactly overjoyed that we've improved the Whopper. Yes, they're less than thrilled that the new Whopper has more beef than Big Mac or Wendy's single and beat both for best taste. And we expect them to be just as happy with the new Whopper meal combo. Whopper, large fries, and medium soft drink for $2.99. Of course, even Burger King can't torment the competition forever. This is a limited time offer.
Aren't you hungry?
Stetson, cologne for men. When your man likes his fragrance with style, Stetson fits. When he likes it easy to wear, Stetson fits. When he likes his fragrance comfortable, Stetson fits. And now, you could win a trip for two to Las Vegas via American Airlines. Stetson's Wheel of Fortune contest with over 1,000 prizes. Stetson fits. Stetson, cologne for men.
Discount Car and Truck Rentals.
We want your business. How far will we go to get it? Right to your front door.
Good morning, discount. That's right, sir. We pick you up at home and drive you back home after your rental. Why? It's part of our service. No, sir, it's free.
Call Discount Car and Truck Rentals. We want your business.
And we'll come right to your front door to get it.
Promotional consideration provided by New Master Roundup Dog Food. The 100% nutritionally complete dog food with the taste that dogs love. New Roundup Dog Food by Master. And Monarch All-Purpose Flour rises above the rest. Makes all your baking lighter and fluffier. Results guaranteed.
Ladies and gentlemen, this tag team match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Morgan's Corner, Arkansas, weighing 285 pounds, Ted Grizzly. His partner, from New York City, New York, weighing 250 pounds, Steve Lombardi. Now introducing their opponents. First, from the Kingdom of Tonga, weighing 260 pounds, King Tonga. His partner from Montreal, Quebec, weighing 245 pounds, Dino Bravo.
You know, Gorilla, I like Dino Bravo's jacket. Did you ever see that dude in the comic strips, Dudley Do-Right?
Dudley Do-Right.
Yeah, Dino Bravo of the Mounted Police. We'd call him Dudley Do-Right Dino.
Oh, my God.
Of the Canadian Mounted Police.
I'm sure Dino Bravo is one of these superstars here in the World Wrestling Federation would take exception to that remark, Jess.
I think it's kind of a nice name for him, Dudley Do-Right Dino.
Right now, King Tonga, the powerhouse from the Isle of Tonga in the South Pacific, in there with Steve Lombardi, who is rapidly making waves here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, I'll tell you, Steve Lombardi's gotten real aggressive lately, and that can only help him.
Oh, nice drop down by Tonga over the top. Nice hip lock catches him coming in. Scoop slam. Wow, that'll slow you down in a hurry. Knife edge drops Lombardi. Tonga off the ropes. Oh, headbutt right to the sternum area. This Tonga's a powerhouse, Jess.
I'll tell you, he took everything right out of Steve Lombardi there. And Lombardi, no slouch in that ring. He's got himself in phenomenal shape.
Certainly is not. Tag made. Dino Bravo in there. Oh, they're going to work on that left arm and shoulder. Steve Lombardi.
Big leg drop by Dudley Dino.
No, I'm sure, Jess, that all the wrestling fans in the World Wrestling Federation are aware that when the World Wrestling Federation superstars invade Saturday night's main event on that Halloween special, they're going to be in for a real treat because you're going to see guys like Andre the Giant trick-or-treating. That's going to be a lot of fun.
Can you imagine what his trick-or-treat bag must look like?
Well, I understand he's going to be dressed as the Big Bad Wolf. Atomic drop applied.
A gunny sack full of candy, right?
How about Bundy and Stud dressed up as Hansel and Gretel going around door-to-door trick-or-treating?
On Monday, November the 4th, Maple Leaf Wrestling and the Stars of the World Wrestling Federation return to the Brantford Civic Center with all the action getting underway at 7:30 p.m. And on Tuesday, November the 5th, Maple Leaf Wrestling presents a spectacular card in the Oshawa Civic Auditorium featuring King Kong Bundy. And on Sunday, October the 27th, promoter Jack Tunney will present another action-packed card in Toronto's Maple Leaf Garden. In an intercontinental title match, Tito Santana puts his title on the line against Cowboy Ace Orton. Hillbilly Jim will battle Big John Studd. Terrible Terry Funk faces the Junkyard Dog. And topping it off, the Battle of the Giants. Andre the French Giant goes up against King Kong Bundy. Remember, that's on Sunday, October the 27th, 7:30 p.m. in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. And join us tonight for the World Wrestling Federation from 7 to 8 p.m. right here on Channel 11.
Dino Bravo hoisting up 300 pounds plus. I like the gumption on that youngster, Jess.
The what?
The gumption.
The gumption.
To go in there and attempt to lift 325 pounds plus. Let's get the official word.
The winners of the match the team of King Tonga and Dino Bravo.
Dino Bravo, King Tonga, chalking up a victory here in the World Wrestling Federation. Let's go back and take a look at how they did it.
Here's the power of Dino Bravo. Big back suplex here. Wham! Oh. Driving the back of the neck and the head into that mat. Knocks Grizzly cold. Dudley Do-Right Dino gets the pin.
Over on top of Ted Grizzly, Dino Bravo, and that exciting team chalks up another victory here in the World Wrestling Federation. We're going to be looking for tremendous things out of that duo in the weeks and months to come, as they are going to certainly carve a mark for themselves. Stay with us, wrestling fans. A most interesting interview coming up right now.
On Monday, November the 4th, Maple Leaf Wrestling and the Stars of the World Wrestling Federation return to the Brantford Civic Center, all the action getting underway at 7:30 p.m. And on Sunday, October the 27th, in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens, promoter Jack Penny has come up with another tremendous card. In tag action, George Wells and S.D. Jones face Jim the Anvil Neidhart and Hitman Bret Hart. Dino Bravo takes on Moondog Spot. In a ladies' world title match, Wendy Richter puts her title on the line against the Spider Lady. Hillbilly Jim faces Big John Studd. Terrible Terry Funk versus the Junkyard Dog. In an intercontinental title match, Tito Santana will risk his title against Cowboy Ace Orton. And topping it off, Andre the French Giant will face King Kong Bundy. My guest at this time, the man who will be going against Big John Studd, Hillbilly Jim.
That's right. Let me tell you something. Right in the Maple Leaf Gardens, there's going to be something everybody's going to want to see. Not only is Andre the Giant going to get his revenge on King Kong Bundy, but I'm going to get to do something I've been wanting to do for a long time. That's step in that ring toe-to-toe with that giant, Big John Studd. Now, let me tell you one thing, John Studd. You're a bit of a bully. I know that. Where I come from, I don't carry on like it. I live and let live. But you've done some things to me that I can't let go unnoticed. Everybody has seen the way you've held my legs and the way that King Kong Bundy splashed me. But let me tell you one thing. I know, because Andre the Giant has told me. He said, "Hillbilly, you can slam that man." He said, "I have done it. And I'm just crazy enough and old country boy enough to believe it. I can slam you, Big John Studd. And I can't wait. And when I pick you up and slam you down to that mat, you're going to know that you're not the bully that you thought you was, boy."
Cousin Junior also on this great card. He'll be going against Iron Mike Sharpe.
Yes, well, Cousin Junior, I've been talking to him. This Iron Mike Sharpe, everybody knows he's from right here in Canada. And he's one tough critter. And he's a man that's in good shape. And I told Cousin Junior, I said, "Cousin Junior, you can't go out there and just take this man easy, because this man here is tough, mighty tough."
Sunday, October the 27th, new starting time, 7:30 p.m., right here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Garden.
The reason J.M. Schneider's customers had such confidence in his luncheon meats was because they never had to guess what went into them. Mothers knew that he used only quality ingredients, quality cuts of beef and pork. And as in J.M.'s day, if you compare a few labels, you'll never find the phrase "may contain" on any package of Schneider's luncheon meats. Think about it. Which luncheon meat would you rather serve your family? At Schneider's, you can still taste the difference quality makes.
That cool, refreshing flavor of Wrigley Spearmint Gum puts a sparkle in your eye, a spring in your step, and makes things lots of fun.
It's that long-lasting taste of Wrigley Spearmint Gum. That refreshing flavor, come on and get you some.
That clean, fresh taste, Wrigley Spearmint Gum. Refreshing flavor that lasts a lot.
It's that long-lasting taste of Wrigley Spearmint Gum.
Esso Motor Oils. Tested on the longest road in the world, where the heat can fry you, or the cold, freeze you solid. That road begins here at the Esso Research Center, where Esso motor oils are driven to the limit to give you the great engine defense you want. Efficient engine performance, longer engine life. Where does this road end? For Esso, it never does. It's coming through for you that makes us better.
Cut your home heating bills. You may save from 25 to 42% with one of our Lennox high-efficiency natural or propane gas furnaces, the new Conservatoire 3 or our famous Lennox Pulse furnace.
My name is Laddie Cuja. If you want personalized service and a good price, call my company, Arrow Heating and Air Conditioning.
Let Easterbrook Brothers help you regain control of your energy costs. Give us a call for a free in-home estimate. Serving Toronto since 1945.
You've never heard of him.
Who are you?
Only the president and three others know he exists.
Jump!
We've got a problem, George.
Some joker walks into one of my plants, and now you're telling me he doesn't exist? The only weapons he needs are his mind and his body.
Who are you?
Now, there's a new name in high adventure. Remo Williams, The Adventure Begins.
Now playing at a Cineplex Odeon theater near you. Check your local listings for details.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Quebec City, weighing 215 pounds, Nelson Veilleux. His opponent, now about to approach the ring. First, I'd like to introduce his beautiful manager, Elizabeth. Now introducing, from Sarasota, Florida, weighing 232 pounds, the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Talk about your excitement. The Macho Man being let down by that beauty right there, Elizabeth.
That's right. Look at, he's got her trained. Look at that. Got her trained, Gorilla.
Oh, he should be opening the ropes for her, Jess.
No way. No way.
You see Bobby the Brain, he didn't come out and open the ropes for his men?
No. Hey, Macho Man, that's why he has Elizabeth as his manager.
Macho Man is running wild here in the World Wrestling Federation, as this guy is excitement personified, and obviously one of the most devastating men in all of professional wrestling. With that leap that he does off the top turnbuckle, Jess, that is devastating.
Oh, yeah, now that... He's telling Elizabeth right where he wants her, and she better do it. Randy Macho Man Savage takes no grief from women. No.
You got to take my rule. Said somebody forgot to take his robe. Well, that's what you have a manager for. Nice arm drag by Jadine as Nelson catches the Macho Man coming in. Side hip takeover. But Nelson, quick, come up with that head scissors, and the Macho Man bails out.
Now, you see how smart Randy was there, the Macho Man? Get it back together, walk around, have a little talk with Elizabeth, and then step back into the ring.
Macho Man just running through everything like a hot knife through butter here in the World Wrestling Federation with one thought in mind, to get the gold currently around the waist of one Hulk Hogan.
And this man just might do it.
Whoa! Understand, on that album that was turned out by the stars of the World Wrestling Federation, the wrestler's album, that the Hulkster has a new theme song on it, Jess. You know
about that? Yeah, he has a new theme song. It was so good, it sent me right into the commode.
Get away. Why you say that, Jess?
Wait till you hear it.
On Monday, November the 4th, Maple Leaf Wrestling and the Stars of the World Wrestling Federation return to the Brantford Civic Center with all the action getting underway at 7:30 p.m. And on Tuesday, November the 5th, Maple Leaf Wrestling presents a spectacular card in the Oshawa Civic Auditorium featuring King Kong Bundy. And on Sunday, October the 27th, promoter Jack Tunney will present another action-packed card in Toronto's Maple Leaf Garden. In an intercontinental title match, Tito Santana puts his title on the line against Cowboy Ace Orton. Hillbilly Jim will battle Big John Studd. Terrible Terry Funk faces the Junkyard Dog. And topping it off, the Battle of the Giants. Andre the French Giant goes up against King Kong Bundy. Remember, that's on Sunday, October the 27th, 7:30 p.m. in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. And join us tonight for the World Wrestling Federation from 7 to 8 p.m. right here on Channel 11.
Count. Look at Elizabeth. She's ecstatic. She's happy.
Elizabeth likes it. You know, I think it was Elizabeth that told him to go up for that second one.
I doubt that very much.
I heard her from the outside. She said, give it to him, Randy.
Macho Man just devouring his opponent here this week in the World Wrestling Federation. Let's go up and get the official word.
The winner of the match, the Macho Man, Randy Savage.
Macho Man admonishing Elizabeth about something. Let's go back and take a look at probably the most devastating maneuver in all of professional sports today. That flying elbow as delivered by the one and only, the Macho Man. Look at the force of this coming down. Right now, wrestling fans, let's go to the body shop with Stud and Bundy.
Good today. I feel real fight. You know, last week there was a big meatball out here when his new airhead manager tried to abuse me. Now, I can tell right now, I don't see him nowhere around now because now my friends are here. Andre the Giant, I'm talking to you. Where are you at now, big man? Because I got Bobby the Brain Heenan. And without a doubt, the most awesome tag team in wrestling history.
Can I ask you some questions, Jesse? You always interview everybody. Was Lou Albano dressed as articulate as I am?
Lou Albano is a complete slob.
Thank you. Would you say this man is the giant of professional wrestling?
I would say the giant stud is the true giant of professional wrestling, height-wise.
Would you say this man is more massive and more devastating than Andre the Giant?
Without a doubt. You've got a man here just as tall as Andre, and you got a man here that's bigger than Andre.
Would you say that Andre the Giant was 100% healthy when you interviewed him?
No. In my honest opinion, the man looked peaked. The man, he had a cave-in in his chest. In weightlifting, we call that a chicken chest.
He had to catch his breath a couple of times, didn't he?
Yes, he did. He couldn't take a deep breath. When he did, it looked like he was in pain. I wonder who's responsible.
I'll tell you, because I'm that kind of a nice guy. The giant John Studd and the ever massive King Kong Bundy.
Say hi, guys.
Right now, Jesse's a pirate's dream.
We don't have a lot of time, Bundy. Just say hi. Just say hi to him.
Hey, friends. How are you all out there? I am the stud. This is King Kong Bundy.
Yeah, and this is the body shop. The pleasure was yours.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Romania, weighing 235 pounds, John Canine. His opponent, from Puerto Rico, weighing 245 pounds, Pedro Morales.
Well, I'm on soon along with Jesse the Body Ventura here at ringside. Jess, is that canine as in dog?
I would guess so. I don't know. I'll tell you one thing, though, about Pedro Morales. Just came off a real successful tour of Egypt. Said he loved it over there. Can't wait to go back again. He's hoping to get a lot more matches over in Egypt.
Are you sure of that, Jeff?
Yes, I'm positive.
Oh, okay. He must have made a lot of money as well.
Well, I'm sure he did, and he was very successful over there. And now we've got him right back here in the World Wrestling Federation, USA.
Well, Pedro Morales, it couldn't help but be successful no matter where he went in the wrestling world. A man who has literally done it all, Jess. Former Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, former holder, co-holder of the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team title, and at one time, even the world's title, Jess.
On Monday, November the 4th, Maple Leaf Wrestling and the Stars of the World Wrestling Federation return to the Brantford Civic Center with all the action getting underway at 7:30 p.m. And on Tuesday, November the 5th, Maple Leaf Wrestling presents a spectacular card in the Oshawa Civic Auditorium featuring King Kong Bundy. And on Sunday, October the 27th, promoter Jack Tunney will present another action-packed card in Toronto's Maple Leaf Garden. In an intercontinental title match, Tito Santana puts his title on the line against Cowboy Ace Orton. Hillbilly Jim will battle Big John Studd. Terrible Terry Funk faces the Junkyard Dog. And topping it off, a battle of the giants. Andre the French Giant goes up against King Kong Bundy. Remember, that's on Sunday, October the 27th, 7:30 p.m. in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. And join us tonight for the World Wrestling Federation from 7 to 8 p.m. right here on Channel 11.
The other guy's name is John K-9, but Pedro, you know, if you ask me, Pedro resembles a little more of a bulldog.
Well, he certainly stays in good shape all the time, as you must in the world of professional wrestling if you want to be successful. Because after all, these guys are making a living off their body. And if anybody knows it, you should know it, Jess. You got to take care of it.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. You take care of your body will take care of you.
That's the way it goes. Newcomer to the World Wrestling Federation, John K-9, receiving some heavy competition in one Pedro Morales. Irake now stops Pedro. He's going to get it bad here, and Pedro Morales is going to do a number on this youngster. Uh-oh, look out. Oh, the southpaw lands a big left hand right to the lower solar plexus. I thought he was going to make him mad, Jess.
Morales is measuring John K-9 right here. What's he going to do with him? He's got something.
Irish whip in, and another big left hand sends the K-9 down to the canvas.
Well, Morales has never been shy about going to the body.
Backbreaker. Wow, well executed. Good night. It's over. Didn't give us that patented Boston crab. However, victorious, easy once he made up his mind to put this youngster away. It certainly didn't take him very long. Let's get the official word.
The winner of the match, Pedro Morales.
Pedro Morales chalking up another one in that tremendous record that he has in the record books. Another victory here this week in the World Wrestling Federation. Here it comes, Jess.
There you see Morales. Look at the strength of Morales, how high he gets him on this back figure. Wham! Right down on the knee, right in the kidney, short rib area. Hooking the leg, which is a sign of a veteran right there. There'll be no kick out. 1, 2, and 3.
Tough to kick out when you don't have both legs free, and sometimes it's even impossible. Plenty of action and excitement, as always, here in the World Wrestling Federation. So don't go away, wrestling fans. A special message from one of the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation coming at you.
Of the stars. You're looking at a small sampling of the excitement that's in store at the Hamilton International Auto Show. You'll see all that's new from North America and the world, plus special features like the Budweiser Double Thunder NASCAR racing team. Come see what's new for 86 all under one roof. Recapture the excitement of the fall new car unveilings. It's all waiting for you at the Hamilton International Auto Show, October 23rd through to the 27th. At the Convention Center in Hamilton, the cars are the stars.
Oh, it's enough to make a grown torturer cry. After 59 extraordinary torture tests, yet another Toshiba business copier has emerged with resistance unbroken. It's all designed to ensure every Toshiba business copier can withstand the most important torture test of all. Your office. Toshiba. Extraordinary standards make extraordinary business copiers.
It was in places like this where top engine protection is a must that Shell developed the technology to formulate TLO, premium motor oil. Today, TLO with the unique additive Shelvis 50 will give your car top engine protection against anything Canadian driving conditions can throw at it. TLO for top engine protection.
Fellow hot dog lovers, Wendy's introduces their new beef hot dog.
Hot diggity, dog diggity, you put cheese on it, you put chili on it, blue chili and cheese on it. Hot diggity, dog diggity, wow. Lots of beef to it, down to the very last bite.
Wendy's new beef hot dogs in a class all their own.
Hot diggity, dog diggity.
Finally, a great Canadian hot dog.
For 75 years, Canadians have rolled on Goodyear tires. Now, Goodyear's premium radios are sale priced during our spectacular 75th anniversary sale. Like Vector, our best all season for exceptional year-round handling. And the famous Goodyear F32S ice radio for extra winter traction. Featured is our superb steel belted radio poly steel from $49.95. Our 75th anniversary sale. Goodyear quality at super sale prices. See your participating Goodyear retailer today.
Promotional consideration provided by Secret Weapon, the exciting new game of espionage. Your mission, to build a secret weapon by obtaining the inventor's blueprints from his secret lab. It's action-packed. Play Secret Weapon tonight. And added touch, your best value in a cake mix. A moist, delicious cake that tastes homemade. The moistness is the added touch. Added touch, your best value.
Ladies and gentlemen, this tag team match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing from parts unknown, weighing 230 pounds, Mr. X. His partner from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing 260 pounds, Iron Mike Sharpe. Their opponents now approaching the ring. First, from Philadelphia, Mississippi, weighing 402 pounds, Uncle Elmer. And his partner from Pigeon Forge, Kentucky, weighing 282 pounds, Cousin Junior.
Album. That's Hillbilly Jim's version of Don't Mess with a Country Boy.
That's right, we got two country boys on here. Speaking of which, Gorilla, did you check out Uncle Elmer's wedding and his wife?
Certainly did. It was a tremendous occasion.
I'll tell you what, she looked like the second place finisher in a pit bull match.
Oh, give me a break, Jess. Uncle Elmer married a very beautiful lady. Was in attendance. I saw one went down. It was tremendous. Huh. As is always the fact when the World Wrestling is in.
Look at this, Jess.
Cousin Junior doing his thing. That's 300 pounds plus. Doing that little hold down.
I wasn't quite sure if Uncle Elmer's wife spoke the I do or marked it.
You're being very facetious now.
No, I'm not. An uglier beast I've ever seen in all my days.
Wrestling fans, don't pay attention to what Jesse's saying because it's an untruth. Cousin Junior doing his thing.
When they say the old saying about a bang over the head, Gorilla.
Oh, give me a break. Now a married man, Uncle Elmer, did it all. As the World Wrestling Federation, on Saturday night, main event is where it took place, Jess, and it was a happening.
On Monday, November the 4th, Maple Leaf Wrestling and the Stars of the World Wrestling Federation returned to the Brantford Civic Center with all the action getting underway at 7:30 p.m. And on Tuesday, November the 5th, Maple Leaf Wrestling presents a spectacular card in the Oshawa Civic Auditorium featuring King Kong Bundy. And on Sunday, October the 27th, promoter Jack Tunney will present another action-packed card in Toronto's Maple Leaf Garden. In an intercontinental title match, Tito Santana puts his title on the line against Cowboy Ace Orton. Hillbilly Jim will battle Big John Studd. Terrible Terry Funk faces the Junkyard Dog. And topping it off, the Battle of the Giants. Andre the French Giant goes up against King Kong Bundy. Remember, that's on Sunday, October the 27th, 7:30 p.m. in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. And join us tonight for the World Wrestling Federation from 7 to 8 p.m. right here on Channel 11.
Came in ringing that cowbell that you like so much.
What size t-shirt do you figure Uncle Elmer wears?
Oh, about a 6X.
Half a bed sheet.
Yeah, 6X. You could use it to cover up your car when you're not wearing it. Mr. X got one right in the kisser.
I heard he changes it once a month, too. What t-shirt?
Come on.
Whether it needs it or not.
Come on. We're in a ferocious mood this week in the World Wrestling.
I don't like these two dudes.
That's obvious.
It's when their music comes on. It gets me on edge.
Well, I heard some of that music that you put out, Jess, and that got me on edge.
I'm not here to argue with you tonight, Gorilla. Okay. As much as you're trying to bait me, and as much as you're trying to get me in one.
Iron Mike Sharpe now, as the tag is made, steps in there with, I'm sure, 500 pounds plus.
Wow, did you see that? He just spit smack in his hand.
Well, that
I would have the referee wipe his hands off on a towel right there.
That means he's getting ready to do some serious stuff.
Not on my body. He wouldn't touch me like that.
How about you and the Macho Man teaming up against those two?
I'll tell you, I'd love to see the Macho Man hammer that Uncle Elmer's noggin.
Iron Mike Sharpe, unsuccessful in the body slam attempt, reaches in once more. Sharpe in excellent physical condition. Sharpe off the ropes now, shoulder block. Didn't even budge Uncle. Barry Light seems to agree with him. He's saying, come on, give me another one. Here's a tag. All right, Mike Sharpe. Wow, big right overhand. And Cousin Jr. ran into the top turnbuckle. Tags his partner as they go to work in a double team effort now. Cousin Jr. on the receiving end. He's a long way from Dodge right now.
Well, Anson Sharpe are being smart to keeping him in the corner, but Jr.'s fighting out. Uh-oh, he's hanging out.
Big mismatch here. 200 or 300 pounds worth. Sharpe comes in illegally and gets one right in the chops. Oh, look at this. Great choke hold. Down goes Mr. X. Uncle Elmer setting him up here, Irish whip. Whammo. Down he goes again. Look out, Cousin Jr. off the rope. Bam, right down on the sternum. One, two, he got him. Nothing much Iron Mike Sharpe could do about it as Uncle Elmer was standing right in front of him. And the fans here in the World Wrestling Federation love that one. There it goes. As Cousin Jr. and Uncle Elmer chalk up another victory here in the World Wrestling Federation. And look at the hoedown that's going down this week right here. Wrestling fans, action and excitement as always. Stay tuned. A special interview coming at you.
There's a new kind of energy rising like the sun, spreading all across the country, touching everyone.
At Petro Canada, our energy will see the future through.
Oh, Canada,
Canada,
our energy is you.
Petro Canada, our energy is Canada.
Tonight on the Dick Beddoes Show, a retrospective look at the American League Championship Series between the Toronto Blue Jays and the Kansas City Royals. It's a special salute to the Blue Jays, a team that captured the imagination of all Canadians with their dramatic drive of 85. Plus, a very special preview of the upcoming World Series of 1985. It all happens on the Dick Beddoes Show tonight at 6:30 on TV 11. Join us.
Hey man, this Halloween, think California. You can win 2 weeks there and ride a wild roller coaster in Roundtree's California Thriller Contest. Details are on all Roundtree Halloween packs of Coffee Crisp, Smarties, Arrow, Kit Kat, and Mirage. Imagine you're on the coast, you understand? You hit the big loop and then snap! You're 15 stories straight up and stop. Now do it all again. Backwards. Stay cool. Roundtree California Thriller Contest. It's some trip.
I've called in some big ones, but I'm still going for the biggest, Lotto 649.
Cookie and I have had some big wins in our day, but we're still going for the biggest, Lotto 649.
I've had some big wins, but I'm still going for the biggest, Lotto 649.
Lotto 649. Now you're talking the big win, and now you're talking two draws a week, Wednesday and Saturday. Only $1 a ticket.
Where's the coffee?
Where's the coffee? Where's the coffee?
Every morning, your local Toyota dealers ask the same question because they know the customer is special, so they make sure there's a fresh pot of hot coffee each morning. So if you want to see some exciting new or used Toyotas, or if you need some great Toyota parts or service, come and have a coffee on us. We really care, because if there weren't a you, there wouldn't be an us. Reminder once again to everyone in the Brantford area that Maple Leaf Wrestling and the Stars of the World Wrestling Federation return to the Brantford Civic Center on Monday, November the 4th, starting time 7:30 p.m. And on Sunday, October the 27th, in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens, promoter Jack Tunney presents another power-packed card. Cousin Junior will face Iron Mike Sharpe. In tag action, George Wells and S.D. Jones take on the Hart Connection, Jim the Anvil Neidhart, and Hitman Bret Hart. Dino Bravo faces Moondog Spot. In a ladies' world title match, Wendy Richter, the ladies' champion, puts her title on the line against the Spider Lady. Hillbilly Jim faces Big John Studd. Terrible Terry Funk takes on the Junkyard Dog. And in an intercontinental title match, Tito Santana will risk his title against Cowboy Ace Orton. And topping it off, Andre the French Giant faces King Kong Bundy. And the manager of King Kong Bundy and Big John Studd, Bobby the Brain Heenan.
That's right. Now, some people can sit around and laugh, and some people think it's funny that Big John Studd has to get in the ring with Hillbilly Jim. They think Hillbilly Jim, coming off that knee injury, coming off that chest injury, he's 100% now. He's going to make sure that Studd pays. They think Andre the Giant, with all his wrath, all 500-some pounds of it, is going to take it out on Bundy. I'm going to tell you two dummies what's going to happen to you. The last time you got in the ring and tried to outsmart me, Hillbilly Jim, which I am manager of the year, you were carted out of there. And Andre the Giant, when you tried to slam John Studd, you tried to cut his hair, what happened to you, big boy? You were carted out of there. And you know who did the damage? This man right here and this man, King Kong Bundy and John Studd.
Take a look at me, Hillbilly Jim. 7 foot plus, nearly 400 pounds of solid muscle. And there's a few things in life I don't like black-eyed peas, cornbread. I don't like hillbillies. I don't like what you stand for. I don't like that good-natured attitude that you come around with. This world does not have a room. This wrestling ring doesn't have a room for good nature. Now, take a good look at me, hillbilly. You're a big man. Andrea the Giant is a bigger man. And look what I'm walking around with, a bag full of his hair. Well, I can't be slammed and I can't be pinned. And when we step into Maple Leaf Gardens, I'm going to drive you right through the center of the ring, punk.
You know, Andre the Giant, the eighth wonder of the world, a very big man, that's right, a big man with a very short memory. If you think back, Andre, the last time you were in the ring in Toronto with King Kong Bundy, they carried you out. That's right, it took eight men to carry you out of that ring, and I'm going to tell you something right now. This time won't be any different. And only this time there's going to be one difference. I'm going to line you up in that corner, and I'm going to give you that big avalanche, and you're going to go down like a giant sequoia. Boom! And the five count, Andre, you've never been beaten, have you? Well, the first time. The first time you get beat, it's not going to be with a three count. It's going to be with a five count. And I'm going to show everybody in Toronto, you don't mess with the Heenan family. You don't mess with Bundy, the big stud and the manager of the year, Bobby Heenan.
You know, King Kong, where I'm going to have a big hole in the floor where the hillbilly's going to be, and I want you to take Andre and stuff him right on top of him.
All right, Stud. You know, Stud, you will be watching when I'm in there with Andre.
I'll be ringside.
I got a riddle for you. What has an IQ of 40 and has 11 teeth?
Gee, I don't know. You got me.
Andre the Giant and Hillbilly Jim.
Remember, that Sunday, October the 27th, the new starting time, 7:30 p.m., right here in Toronto's Maple Leaf Gardens. Don't you dare miss it. I'd like to remind everyone in the Oshawa area that Maple Leaf Wrestling will present a spectacular card in the Oshawa Civic Auditorium on Tuesday, November the 5th. All the action gets underway at 8 p.m., and this big band beside me, King Kong Bundy, will be in the feature event.
That's right, and you know they can find a man with the guts to get in the ring with King Kong Bundy. You know what's going to happen to him. He's going to get thrown into the turnbuckle. He's going to get squashed with a big avalanche, and he's going to get a five count. One, two, three, four, five.
Remember, that's the Oshawa Civic Auditorium, Tuesday, November the 5th. All the action getting underway at 8 p.m.
Macho Man, most impressive this week just here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Oh, yeah, the Macho Man looked great. Elizabeth looked great. And I thought Uncle Elmer
looked great.
Marriage isn't
Jesse said Uncle Elmer looked great. Coming up next week, wrestling fans, superstars of the World Wrestling Federation, the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Craig the Hammer Valentine and Brutus Beefcake, JYD, the Bulldogs, and a friend of yours, Corporal Kirshner.
That's right. Nothing but action right here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Gorilla Monsoon for Jesse the Body Ventura saying so long till next week.
Catch the action with hosts John Hinnan and Walter Heaney at the Walker Special Old Bowling Classic tomorrow afternoon at 1 here on TV 11.
The Leafs versus the Penguins, followed by Don Cherry's Grapevine with Cliff Thorburn, Wednesday on CHCH, TV 11.